his deeply corrupted spirit and troubled.
Where have you laid him?
He asked.
Come and see, Lord,
they replied. Jesus wept. Then the Jews said,
see how he loved him.
But some of them said,
could not he who opened the eyes of the blind man have kept this man from dying?
Jesus, once more deeply moved, came to the tomb. It was a cave with a stone laid across the entrance.
Take away the stone, he said.
But Lord,
said Martha, the sister of the dead man,
by this time there is a bad odor, for he has been there 4 days.
Then Jesus said, did I not tell you that if you believed you would see the glory of God? So they took away the stone. Then Jesus looked up and said,
Father, I thank you that you have heard me. I knew that you always hear me, but I said this for the benefit of the people standing here, that they may believe that you sent me.
When he had said this, Jesus called in a loud voice,
Lazarus, come out!
And the man came out with his hands and feet wrapped with strips of linen, and a cloth around his face. Jesus said to them,
take off the grave clothes
and let him go.
To stone you, and yet you are going back there?
Jesus answered, are there not 12 hours of daylight? A man who walks by day will not stumble, for he sees by this world's light. It is when he walks by night that he stumbles, for he has no light. After he had said this, he went on to tell them, our friend Lazarus has fallen asleep, but I am going there to wake him up. His disciples replied,
Lord, if he sleeps, he will get better.
Jesus had been speaking of his death, but his disciples thought he meant natural sleep. So then he told them plainly, Lazarus is dead, and for your sake I am glad I was not there, so that you may believe. But let us go to him. Then Thomas, called Didymus, said to the rest of the disciples,
let us also go, that we may die with him.
On his arrival, Jesus found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb. Less than 2 miles from Jerusalem, and when the Jews had come.
now, God will give you whatever you ask.
Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise again." Martha answered,
"I know he will rise again in the resurrection at the last day."
Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?"
"Yes, Lord,"
she told him.
"I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, who was to come into the world."
And after she had said this, she went back and called her sister Mary aside.
"The teacher is here,"
she said,
"and is asking for you."
When Mary heard this, she got up quickly and went to him. Now, Jesus had not yet entered the village, but was still at the place where Martha had met him. When the Jews who had been with Mary in the house, comforting her, noticed how quickly she got up and went out, they followed her, supposing she was going to the tomb to mourn there. When Mary reached the place where Jesus was and saw him, she fell at his feet and said,
"Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died."
When Jesus saw her weeping, and the Jews who had come along with her also weeping, he was deeply moved in spirit and troubled.
"Where have you laid him?" he asked.
"Come and see, Lord,"
they replied. Jesus wept. Then the Jews said,
"See how he loved him."
But some of them said,
"Could not he who opened the eyes of the blind man have kept this man from dying?"
Jesus, once more deeply moved, came to the tomb. It was a cave with a stone laid across the entrance.
"Take away the stone," he said.
"But Lord,"
said Martha, the sister of the dead man,
"by this time there is a bad odor, for he has been there 4 days.
Then Jesus said, "Did I not tell you that if you believed, you would see the glory of God?" So they took away the stone. Then Jesus looked up and said,
"Father, I thank you that you have heard me. I knew that you would always hear me, but I said this for the benefit of the people standing here, that they may believe that you sent me." When he had said this, Jesus called in a loud voice,
"Lazarus, come out!"
The dead man came out, his hands and feet wrapped with strips of linen and a cloth around his face. Jesus said to them,
"Take off the grave clothes and let him go."
Therefore, many of the Jews who had come to visit Mary and had seen what Jesus did put their faith in him. But some of them went to the Pharisees and told them what Jesus had done. Then the chief priests and the Pharisees called a meeting of the Sanhedrin.
"What are we accomplishing?"
they asked.
"Here is this man performing many miraculous signs.
We let him go on like this, everyone will believe in him, and then the Romans will come and take away both our place and our nation."
Then one of them, named Caiaphas, who was the high priest that year, spoke up.
"You know nothing at all. You do not realize that it is better for you that one man die for the people than that the whole nation perish."
He did not say this on his own, but as high priest that year, he prophesied that Jesus would die for the Jewish nation. And not only for that nation, but also for the scattered children of God, to bring them together and make them one. So from that day on, they plotted to take his life. Therefore, Jesus no longer moved about publicly among the Jews. Instead, he withdrew to a region near the desert, to a village called Ephraim, where he stayed with his disciples. When it was almost time for the Jewish Passover, many went up from the country to Jerusalem for their ceremonial cleansing before the Passover. They kept looking for Jesus, and as they stood in the temple area, they asked one another,
"What do you think? Isn't he coming to the feast at all?"
But the chief priests and Pharisees had given orders that if anyone found out where Jesus was, he should report it so that they might arrest him. Chapter 11. Now, a man named Lazarus was sick. He was from Bethany, the village of Mary and her sister Martha. This Mary, whose brother Lazarus now was sick, was the same one who poured the oil on the Lord and wiped his feet with her hair. So the sisters sent word to Jesus,
"Lord, the one you love is sick."
When he
you are the Christ, the Son of God, who was to come into the world.
And after she had said this, she went back and called her sister Mary aside.
The teacher is here,
she said,
and is asking for you.
When Mary heard this, she got up quickly and went to him. Now, Jesus had not yet entered.